3 months. I give myself 3 months to explore and go deeper into the dance. When I see something beautiful, something amazing, I get inspired. And once I get inspired, I can do pretty much everything and anything. That was the situation with meeting with Maite. She inspired me to dance, and she inspired me to learn and be better. Not only as a dancer, but as a person as well. The first time I saw her dancing, she was real, and she was very free and very expressive. And from that point, I knew right away that I need her to teach me that.
Julia approached me and asked if I could teach her a private lesson. I told her we will meet, we'll do an evaluation, see what she needs. Her way of presenting herself, it was very self-confident and very strong. And I knew she was trying a little bit too hard to please the leaders, right? She was very, you know, self-concerned instead of thinking and enjoying her own movement, which was already very beautiful and very elegant. I recommended to her that she will focus more to go inside and feel more her own movement and figure out and discover her own dancing. She loved the idea. I could see how her eyes bright up, says like, my own dancing. Oh yeah, I love that.
If I see something, if I want something, I need to do it now. I need to do intensive. I need to jump and go deep right away. That's why the intensive program that Maite suggested was perfect for me. I was willing to do the work and do the homework and do exercises, do whatever it takes, do whatever she wants me to do to get better.
I am the first one in my family that wanted to dance. I grew up in a very little village in Valencia, and the first time I observed a class on ballet, I melt with the music and with the movement, and I was like, mommy, I want to do this. I saw flamenco, and I wanted to do that too. The same thing happened with the ballroom, and then I just went crazy with the ballroom. Latin dance, jazz. I was in my 20s, and I was performing, I remember that night, in La Sala Canal in Valencia. I sat with my favorite choreographer, Salvador Peiro, and we just had in front of us like a couple dancing the tango, and they were improvising. I thought it was the most beautiful thing, the most magical thing ever. So that was it. I was hooked. So there was not much tango at that time in Spain, especially in Valencia. So I had to research what I'm going to do, because I have to learn this and I have to do it now, like Julia, you see. So I just came to New York because New York fits my versatility.
Why tango? It's absolutely beautiful. It's graceful. It's sensual. And it's very intimate. That's what I like. I like to have deep experiences in my life. And I think tango has it. I think tango allows me to go deeper in myself, to learn more things about myself and about others. I think it's my dance.
My favorite tango music, it all depends on who I'm dancing with, where I'm dancing, and how is my mood. Sometimes I'm Piazzolla, sometimes I Pugliese, sometimes I'm Arienzo or Di Sarli. Tango for me is the most complex and the most intelligent dance. It's so sensual. It's so elegant, passionate. The fact that it's so intelligent and so intuitive, and you have to dance it with a partner, is even more challenging. So I love tango. And it's a quiet challenge, it's a peaceful challenge. Because if you hear and dance the tango, it's like you're dancing in silence.
When I've seen the people dancing close embrace for the first time, it was kind of intimidating. It felt kind of uncomfortable, restricted, and tight.
A lot of women come to me after dancing many years, feeling really bad about their own dancing, about their improvement. They feel stuck. They have had all these experiences that they were not pleasant.
It shows in the face, it shows in their bodies and their feet.
They find themselves lost, they find themselves feeling uncomfortable, too tight, you know, shriveled. Leaders are learning too. They are not perfect. They are in their process. So you have to learn how to own your dancing and how to feel comfortable, even with the most terrible leader. You have to find that. That's freedom for you. And it's a very interesting path.
You can extend as much as you can.
After dancing so many years, I had very good leaders and very good partners, and I had difficult leaders. So all this experience have allowed me to help women when they come to me, to let them understand that it might not be totally their fault. Then we work in what they are doing wrong.
So let's say you're going forward, then you go inside, then your torso turns, you see?
And what they experience is when they go back to the dance floor and they see the difference.
I wish women be brave enough to tell the person who they're dancing with how does it feel to dance with this person. It's not only going to serve the woman, but it's also going to make the man a better leader. I think it's a lack of communication. We need to talk more with each other.
Being a follower is an incredible opportunity. You need to be knowing your own movement, enjoying your own movement, and then allowing the creativity of somebody else, your partner, at that moment that is dancing with you, to do anything that they think in a second. And you have to have the confidence, the listening skills, and the ability on your body to react and to inspire at the same time the next move. I teach many male students as well. When they come to me, you know, some of them are just thinking that everything is fine, that they're doing fantastic, that it's all the woman's fault. Others are very curious about, you know, what they can do better. And I show them what they're doing, how it feels. And then, do you want to see it like that or you want to feel like that? How do you want her to feel? Once they see that difference, they don't want to do what they were doing before.
Less movement here. No, less movement. That's it, better. Less. Okay, better. That's it.
A good partner is someone who doesn't make me think too much, who doesn't constrict me on his embrace, and who allows me to move how I need to. To feel wonderful to a woman, it's very easy to achieve, actually. You just have to be willing to break your own barriers and work on your ego. Listen to what it feels right. My male students go out there after a few sessions and they're like, oh my God, I'm getting so many compliments. And it's very simple. They're like, oh, I wish I knew this. It's so simple. A step's probably the most difficult part. But a lot of males are concentrating a lot on steps and the musicality, you know, they have this responsibility of leading. It becomes tough for them, and that's what they focus on instead of why they have going to learn how to dance in the first place, which was to feel wonderful and share that with a woman. After 20 years of teaching, I started developing new methods. A tango student needs to work on presence. I'll use flamenco techniques to increase that passionate strength.
Take your time to step. Feel your legs, your entire body, saying what you want to say.
I use all that I learned in ballet for elegance, balance, from jazz, you know, the sassiness of it. I love to see my students gaining so much self-confidence to achieve the things that they thought it was impossible, to see how they fill up with this enthusiasm and curiosity. And I feel that empowerment that empowers me to also teach them the more deep and even more effectively. And I love the process. I just love the process. I love teaching one-to-one. And you have to get deep. You know, you get to know them. They get to know you. We break a lot of barriers together. We transform our egos together. So it creates a lot of beautiful moments, exciting moments, enthusiastic moments, and really tough moments. It's a natural friendship that normally grows. Julia wanted to take her dancing to the next level and do the things that she kind of knew she could do, and she wanted to do it fast.
I went to see a tango show, and that tango show made me fall in love with tango. So, and that was the level that I wanted to achieve.
So I was okay with that, but of course I had my own agenda, and I wanted her to even explore more deep what she even dreamed that she could do.
The training process was extremely diverse.
We work on balance, we work on elasticity, flexibility, strength, stamina, coordination, presence, stage presence, and of course, a lot of steps and patterns.
We went through molinetes and ochres and ganchos to discovering the energy within. So it's much more than the technique and musicality. It goes deeper in you. Of course, if you're willing to discover that and learn that.
As you get older, you learn to trust your own internal voice. So when you are teaching, you're seeing the body movement, but you also are hearing all these thoughts and all these insights that you get to pick from your students. And once you have all this information, then you know how to talk to them, and you know how to make them go over that barrier and like this fast. I like to be very encouraging. I'm very enthusiastic. So I like to infuse that energy and that spirit into everything that they do. And I force them to put it out. They all have it. They just have to be, you know, pull out of them. We use chairs to work on precision.
You trust that chair, you know where you are. Vamos. Esa. That's good.
I start talking to her about meditation. She was like, what in the world? I'm here to learn tango, right? But it was very important that she will go inside and understand her breathing, for example, to relax all her body and to move more fluidly.
Still, it's too kind of contracted, release.
Then we work, for example, on feeling the floor. I made her take her shoes off and just enjoy and feel all the qualities of the floor and the strength that you can get from that.
You learn how to be attached to the ground, in the same time use the energy from the ground and do beautiful turns and steps. Enjoy that communication.
Brush, point, stretch, push up.
Some of the exercises she loved, like the ones we do in the bars, so she gets like all these nice kicks.
Point your toe, does nothing happen, it's pressure up. Essa! I want to learn one more. I know it's hard. Dale! Yeah! And the last one, don't worry about it, just go, whatever.
But some others, she really was like, oh my God, I'm about to quit. For example, one where I stand behind her and I said, now you're going to follow me with your eyes closed. And she's like, well, you're behind me. I cannot see you. What are you talking about? And then she, you know, she had to experience that there is a lot of our brain that we're not using, and it's very alert, and she could follow and she could feel it, and it was beautiful.
There was one exercise that really deeply impacted me. She taught me how to take the energy within me and pass it to the partner that I'm dancing with, and to move that person without even touching him or her. You learn the most important thing in tango. You learn the connection. And I think that's tango, not the steps, not the embrace. It's very important as well, but that's not it. It's more than that.
I'm very happy about the results. I think Julia has overcome a lot of fears, grown a lot in even more self-confidence with dancing, and open up a lot of new paths that she's willing to explore. So she's very curious about it, and she knows that this dance road, it has no end. So there's a lot to do. I'm still pushing. I'll keep pushing.
The most important part is to be comfortable with myself. That was the goal. And I think it is accomplished. Well, maybe almost there, but I certainly see the huge difference in 3 months.
The teacher is there to lead you, but you have to do your own exploration. You are in your own body. You know what it feels right. You know what is difficult to you. So the student needs to really go inside and ask questions and challenge the teacher. And that's what we are here for, to even challenge them more with every answer we give them.
When you experience Maite as a teacher, she makes you work hard. Of course, if you wouldn't to. She inspires you as a teacher, as a person. The most important part, she shows you that everything is possible. Tantra occupies a big part of my life right now. Being self-employed and running the business, I thought I would not have time for something else, but I do. Because if you want something really bad, if you enjoy something, you always have time. You sleep less, you eat less, but you'll always have time. Once you want something, you have to do it. Otherwise, what's the point of living? Learning tango and movement in general opens your sensuality. And it's not about the other person who is dancing with you. It's absolutely totally about you. It's inside of you.
For me, dancing tango, it's about listening to your own heartbeat, to the music, and to your partner. There's, of course, steps that you have to learn and rules of communication, but it's not about the steps, it's about the feeling. It's about the joy, the passion, and the willing that you are to share with somebody else. If not, you can just dance on your own. It's fine, but not tango.
I'm dancing tango not because I know the steps and I want to do the steps better. I'm dancing tango because I want to explore that sensuality in the dance. It makes me more sensual. I find this feeling within me. And I like it a lot. It expands your dance. It expands you as a person, as a woman. It makes you more beautiful and happy and joyous and incredibly grateful, especially to the person who taught you how to do that.
I think if one day I'm not able to dance, I don't know, I'll dance in bed. I'll dance with my eyes, with my eyelashes. Whatever I can move, I will. And if not, I'll dance with my mind, with my dreams, with my breath.